It has to do with intent. It has to do with the energy that you're doing it with. You see, we're taught to be good little go-getters. Go-getters lose. They blow it. We want to be good little go-givers. Because the law says what you put out will come back. The universe will reward you by law. This is all very scientific. Yet it happens with every person every time. Now, I found the secret, and it was pretty basic. It was simply sit down, decide what you want, write it on a card, carry the card in your pocket, and read it as often as possible every day. So I wrote on the card that I wanted to have in my possession by New Year's Day of 1970. I gave myself a decade to do this deal. And $25,000. I really didn't believe it would happen. But you know something? I kept reading. I don't know why, but I kept reading. And I did exactly what the author said. I kept reading the card. And I kept reading it, and I kept reading it. Now, because I kept reading it, I started to think of earning money. Prior to that, I was thinking of debt. If you had asked me and I said I was thinking of earning money, I wasn't. I was thinking of debt. If your goal is to get out of debt, I guarantee you'll probably be in debt till you die. Because we become what we think about. Yet whatever you think about, you attract. You literally magnetize yourself to it. That's all I was ever thinking about was debt. But I started to think of earning money. Somebody said there's good money cleaning floors. So I said, I'm not proud. I'll clean floors. Well, I started to clean one office. Then I got another one. Do you know in less than 5 years, I was cleaning offices in Toronto, Montreal, Boston, Cleveland, Atlanta, London, England. The thing took off like a rocket. Now, what really changed? I think something inside shifted, but I didn't know what it was. And I bought this book and I was giving it to everybody. And nothing happened in their life. Then I got into Earl Nightingale's condensed narration of the book. And I would drive around with a portable battery-operated record player, and I would keep playing that record over and over and over again. And everybody was starting to wonder about me. Proctor's listening to this guy talk to him, and he's saying the same thing because it's on a record. I mean, he doesn't change the story. And I'm listening to this, and I'm reading the same book. I was starting to wonder about myself. But everything just kept changing, kept changing, kept changing. And I'd give the record to people, and I'd give the book to people, and nothing happened. So I reasoned that someone had to know why I changed, and they've either written it in a book or they're talking about it. So I made up my mind. I would read every book that was ever written if I had to, but I was going to find out what happened to me. And I have never stopped studying. Now, some of what I found out, I'm going to share with you. And since Michael is trapping this on a DVD, you'd be wise to get it and watch it over and over and over again. No, seriously, because what I'm going to share with you is probably the most valuable information you could ever lay your hands on. And I often mention I've got license to brag about everything I talk about because none of it's mine. I have just gathered this information from some of the wisest people in the world, and I have been absolutely obsessed with trying to figure out why we do what we do. And of course, you don't even have to be too quick. If you study the same thing for 40, 50 years, I mean, you're going to start to learn something about it. So that's what we're talking about. Now, I want to suggest that you make up your mind you're going to get in what we call the success zone. It's a way of thinking. Now, get this. If 95, 96% of the population are blowing it, if 1% of the population are earning about 95% of all the money, you're not going to get a whole lot of people agree with what you do. Most people are going to look at you kind of strange. What are you going there for? You went there last month. What are you listening to that for? You listened to that before. What are you reading? What do you read the same book over and over for? They don't understand. And you see, they're advertising their ignorance by the questions they ask. When we get into the success zone, everything in our life starts to change. But understand this, you're going to be a bit of an odd. You're out of the box. You're not one of the masses. And when you get out of the box, your whole world starts to shift.